Welcome to this video. This is actually the third video for the series Introduction to AngularJS from w3schools.com. This is Saeed. I'm a software engineer from Toronto, Ontario, Canada. This is my blog. This is in Bengali, and this is all the videos probably you are watching from here. Anyway, so this is the topic, AngularJS introduction. Yeah, we told what AngularJS is in our first video. This is the third one. AngularJS is a JavaScript framework for web applications or web-based mobile applications, and it is suitable for single page applications to make the web-based application look like more of a mobile native application and without back and forth, and making it more smooth, that kind of thing. Anyway, my microphone is giving me a trouble. I hope it's still recording. I have to fix it. It's the connection problem. So as we saw, AngularJS actually provides some more directives, provides attributes. I think in HTML tag, you know, there are tag like title, value, and all those things. And AngularJS provides some more directives. Actually, directives is the way that makes an HTML application is AngularJS application, HTML page, AngularJS page. I think it directives provides the interaction and the nature and behavior, output, controls, flow, everything is there. So with this and directives, it provides it. And another concept is expressions. Expressions actually related to more of view, and you can embed data into HTML pages using the expression. Yeah, I think expression is ngbind directives. Actually, ngbind, that is also a directive. Okay, directive actually is a high level concept. It includes many things. And expression is just an expression in another language. You can sum multiple variables or multiple strings or get data from some objects using this expression or through the variables in expressions. But I think what the way you do, sometimes you will be binding HTML page with the expressions to the data. I think to show the data in HTML pages, you will need expressions and ngbind. And ngbind is also a directive. There are other directives like ngclick and ngmodel, ngapp. There are many other stuffs. Okay, AngularJS is a JavaScript framework, so you have to link to the AngularJS framework from your HTML page. That's how an HTML page becomes a AngularJS page or AngularJS application. Yeah, so you can see this is a CDN they are using, hosted. There are good and bad of this, mostly better. Distributed JavaScript file can be added to your page with a script tag. They're telling distributed because if they are using a CDN, so probably their server is hosted around across the web, and probably it will be using the closer one, the faster one for your application. Sometimes you can also become a hosted host of some particular libraries or particular applications. Okay, yeah, I'm kind of not reading exactly, but following the flow of this W3 schools thing. Anyway, as you are telling the directive thing, and directives what makes an application Angular application. So whenever you put, I think whenever you are putting this ng app, that it becomes Angular. So ng app you can provide in the body tag, HTML tag. Actually did not use it that way, but you can use in the body tag ng app. Probably you can use it in HTML tag. I will check. And then you can also use it in div or some other HTML tag. then only that part will behave as the AngularJS example, AngularJS application, and you'll be able to Angular define directives and controllers and whatever you save for that particular section. So ngapp makes an application, ng AngularJS application. Ng model it actually binds the controls, like say input controls, text area controls, checkbox controls. The HTML controls, ng model binds those HTML controls to the data, binds data with HTML controls with ng model. And ng model, I think you probably can link to controller, scope variables, scope model. You can do it through ng model. And ng bind, it probably is more on the view side. I think for the web page, you bind application data or data from database or from here and there, or from database or from JSON file. From whatever way you get the data, you use ng bind for the linking to insert embed data into HTML page, HTML view, or AngularJS view, whatever you say. Yeah, concept is sometimes important, but when you are doing actually writing the code, building application, yeah, if you are more or less appropriate, it should be all right. Many times, just the analogy and similarity code reuse, you can make the application. Yeah, conceptual understanding for sure is very important. Yeah, it makes stuff easier. You'll be doing by understanding, and that makes stuff easier for sure. So this is a simple example. You can see ng app. Yeah, you can put some stuff here, but for sure, for now, yeah, let it empty. And you see this is the input box, input control, text box control, ng model. It is a name model. We are not linking to controller scope. You're just moving to another model. Then model name is name. So ng bind, I think it is what you will see. It is a control, but it is what you will see in the output in the HTML page itself. So ng bind, it is a linking to this model, name model. So what will happen for this text box, whatever someone will type, and that will be shown here. Okay, probably as we have information name, so you can say it's taking from here and putting it there. Yeah, so you see it, right? Okay, we went from here. So ng app, we told ng model, we told ng bind, we told. I think they probably are explaining this application. Okay, so ng app, it's telling that the deep part is an Angular application. Or according to W3 Schools language, deep element is the owner of an AngularJS application. So this part becomes an AngularJS application. If you'd be putting body, then it should be becoming an AngularJS application. Logically, HTML should work. Okay, I have to see, but I did not use it there. So ng model, as you are telling, it's a data binding to control. So what it are telling, it binds the value of the input field to the application variable name. Value application variable name. Ng bind, I think the inner HTML, whatever will be in this inner HTML, to the application variable name. Okay. So yeah, ng-init, if you want to initialize some variable, you can use ng-init. So it is telling it's an AngularJS application. Ng-init, we are defining a variable and then we are assigning a value, John. Okay, initializing. We can manipulate this variable inside model and controller, but that's coming. Okay, ng app, init or ng bind, those are not valid HTML. HTML language itself does not recognize them. So you can just put data ng app, data ng init. There is still AngularJS application, but also HTML validator will not mark them as invalid. Expressions are written inside double curly braces. Double braces. Yeah, it's pretty natural. The output will be exactly where the expression is. 5 plus 5, it will be 10. NGAP is a must because it's an AngularJS application. So it's not it doesn't matter, because if AngularJS evaluates, then I think previously it was there is nothing to evaluate. Now this is a string, so it evaluates to like this. Previously it was dumping. Okay, name, why they are giving this example again? Okay, AngularJS application. I think it's a module based. The total application, it itself is a module, and there you can have other custom modules, sub modules that you can have. You can define your own module. The application itself is a module. Controllers is the controls the flow of the control, just the MVC model does. The controller controls flow. An ng app directive, for sure it defines the application, defines the controller. Okay, ng controller. One good thing about ng controller is, I think you can for an HTML section, say div, you can assign ng controller to that div, and you can give a controller name. You can define your own controller, so I think that controller will be only for that particular section, it will not go outside. So you can see, yeah, this is the application controller, my control. It's a custom control, so you have to define a control, like it will be app.controller. You have to say app.controller and you have to create the controller there. And app, I think you also have to create the application module. If I'm as I just directly told app dot, okay, yeah, the example is just here. I am trying hard. App, yeah, you can see angular dot module. It is just defining the application module, the total application as a module, app. Then app dot controller, then you are giving the name of the controller, and then you are defining the function. Function here, some scope variable. Yeah, you could define some more functions under this controller that will be coming very shortly. So ng model, so this is variable name, this is variable name, so they will be coming from this. As this is part of my controller, my controller scope variable first name, my controller scope variable last name. Here we define some variable ng init. Now it's coming through controller. So first name, last name, initial, first name, last name, John Doe. So both will be taking from here. Okay, so you know how to declare a controller and also declare the application module itself. Modules and define applications on the high level. So you are creating an application and giving it a name. Controllers, control applications, some scope variables that you are using in the model. Anyway, this is for it. I'll be going to the expression section in a separate video. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye.